Good morning. This talk is about OSINT tools that we can find in Python ecosystem for auditing the IP address, a domain, a site, website, and so on. This tool is complemented, was made for EuroPython. In this talk, I was talking about the Python pen testing tools, and it's complemented for this talk. In this talk, I will talk about open source tools that are available in GitHub and Bitbucket repositories. And the proof of concepts are available in my GitHub repository personal. And in this talk, we will see some of these proof of concepts. I have proof of concept for Shodan, for obtaining links for a URL or domain, extracting metadata from images and documents, connecting with Twitter, obtain the geolocation of an IP address or domain, and some scripts for other proof of concepts for testing the security of a domain or IP address. This is the main points I will tell. I will make a little introduction to OSINT, what is OSINT. Later, I will comment what are the main service that we can use for obtain Boolean information for services. In this case, I will center in census and Shodan. Later, I will comment what are the main tools developing with Python for obtain basically information that is public in social networks, in the service like Shodan and census. And later in I will comment some proof of concepts relating with geolocation, getting metadata information, and other examples with Twitter, footprinting tools, and so on. Well, what is OSINT? OSINT basically we can consist in obtaining information from public in servers, in internet in general. Basically, what we have to do is first define a specific target. That is what is the target that we want to audit the security. What information we can obtain with OSINT? Basically, a lot of information. We can obtain information from social media, email, photos, images, videos. We can obtain also information about an IP address, the physical and the home IP address, for example. We can obtain also information from a network, what is the infrastructure of a network, the domains, subdomains, and other information related with operational data with the network. Well, basically, this is the information that we can obtain. We will center in obtain. We can obtain geolocation, IP address, an email address of a person, the telephone number, usernames in social networks like Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, and so on, and also extract metadata information from images that we can get from Twitter or Facebook, and other information that is available in servers that is public, and getting vulnerabilities with from a specific service that are available in these servers. Well, the first service that we'll comment is census. Census is a database, a big database. In this screen capture, we can see that we can download a JSON of 600 gigabytes that contains public host, basically our IP address, that contains all information about a specific IP address. This site provides an API, a simple API, and we can share by IP address and domain. And basically, with doing a GET request, we can obtain information related with the location of the domain, certificates, subdomains, URLs, order IP address, and so on. The other service that we have for obtaining all this information is Shodan. Shodan is a big data for obtain information about IP address and discover vulnerabilities in these domains. It has a developer API for developers, and with Python, Python provides a library, a module called Python Shodan that is very easy to use. First, we need to get the API key. The API key is needed for making the request to the service, and this API key we obtain this API key where we register in the Shodan site as developer. And basically, what we can do is obtain information about specific hosts. Looking the host, we can call the host method, passing the IP address or the domain, and we obtain all this information. In this script counter, we can see that we can obtain the IP address, the organization, and for each port that the port is open, it's showing more information about this service. In this case, it detects that the port 22 is open and shows information and is showing information about the certificates in this server. Or this script is available in the GitHub repository that I have all proof of concepts. Basically, what this does for checking data in a specific IP address, we can check this information accessing to the shodan.eu/hod/IP address. We can check that the information that provides in the site is the same that we can see that when we execute the script. Also, with Shodan, we can detect vulnerabilities that are available in the CVE database. The CVE is the common vulnerability and exposures database that in the database are registered all vulnerabilities known for servers, operating systems, specific versions of the servers, and so on. And also, if detects vulnerabilities, we can exploit this vulnerability, searching the specific exploit for the vulnerability that has found. Shodan also provides a developer API. This is a rich API that is well documented, that has very good documentation. And basically, what we can do is all that we can do with the site, we can do it in the REST API, searching, make search by port, by site, by service, and we can see also all the queries that are. That other people are doing in the site. The first tool I will comment is Recon NG. Recon NG is available in Bitbucket. is actively maintained in Bitbucket, and basically what it does is very modular. and save all correct information in database. Internally, you use a SQLite database, and these are the dependencies of this tool. Basically, it's a Python, is developed in Python 2, because it's using mechanize. Mechanize is only compatible with Python 2. And internally, for example, for starting metadata from PDF documents, is using PyPDF 2. Also, is using the NSPython, LXML for parsing information, extracting information. Is using this parser for obtaining the information more relevant. This is the main script capture for this tool. Basically, the functionality is similar to Metasploit. Do you know Metasploit? Well, the use is very similar. Is used, but you can use this tool by modules. You can put the show modules command, and you see the modules that are available in the tool. In this script capture is from the Bitbucket repository, and we can see that it's very easy found the modules that we are interested in the case that we need to see the code and how it's developed. This is one of the modules, mail tester. This module allows checking if a mail address is valid or not. Basically, what it does is connecting to mailtester.com service and check if the email address is valid. And basically, for executing this module, we can execute the show options and see what are the parameters of the module. And in an easy way, we can check if email address is valid or not. And for example, if the email address is valid, we can use this username, for example, for searching this user in social network profiles and other service, for example. Another module is the verb search. This module allows detecting if an email address has been compromised by service. For example, in the last month, we see that, for example, Dropbox has been a compromised email accounts that have not updated the password. And with this tool, we can check if an email address has been compromised in database by hackers, for example. With this tool, also, we can check subdomains for a specific domain. And also, it connects to Shodan API. In this case, it's using the REST API for obtain the information that has seen before. Basically, what it does is obtain the information in JSON format, and in a nice way, we can parse the information that returns Shodan. Well, the next tools I will comment is the Harvester. The Harvester is one of the oldest tools made with Python. If I remember, it has 4 years in the GitHub repository. And basically, what is that? This tool is obtain information about domains, IP address, subdomains from a specific domain. Basically, this tool is provides many modules for making search in many search engines like Google, Bing, Twitter, Yandex, and so on. And internally, it's using also Solan for getting the information, public information for a specific domain. The basic modules that use this tool are HTTP lib, socket, request, and Soda. This is an example where we can see that with the D parameter we specify the domain that we want to test, and with the B parameter we define what is the share engine for making the request. In this case, we are using Google over PyCon.org, and we see the email found and other hosts that have found the information about this domain. Well, another interesting tool that we can find that are developed with Python is OSINT framework. This tool is developed in Python 2.7 and is available in GitHub repository, and also we can install with PV install. It's available in the official Python repository. And an interesting functionality is that we can integrate it with Maltego. Do you know Maltego? Okay, Maltego, we will see later an example. Maltego basically is a tool for obtain information in an intelligent way from a domain, an email address, and so on. Later we will see an example. Basically, these are the main modules that this tool is developed. It's using internally using Beautiful Soup for extracting links and parsing the data. It's using also requests, mechanize, PDNS for resolving name servers, Python Whois for recovering information for a specific whois the person of the property of the domain, also connect with Twitter, with TwiPy, with Skype, and also we can say with an interesting future, it has an interesting future for multi-processing, is using the process Kiwi and pull submodules for making requests in parallel for optimizing the request. This tool is interesting because it has different scripts. Each one we can launch separately with each of other. And basically what we can do is, for example, if we want to discover over a username what are the other accounts related with the username that we are auditing, for example, or the site, we can check the usernames, other usernames that are related with this username. In this case, we are searching with Twitter, and we obtain that in the Twitter social profile, we have all these accounts related with PyCon. We have another script called usufi.py that's searching with a specific username in a this script is searching in 200 platforms available in internet, and basically what provides is information about what are the with the same with username what are if we found with the same username if we found another accounts in other social profile networks. In this case, we see that with PyConES, we detect other accounts in Twixy, in Fabstar, in Cloud, and so on. Another script, interesting script, is that check IP details that passing a domain, we can obtain information about location, servers, IP address, and interesting functionalities, as I mentioned, is integrated with Maltego. Maltego, this tool has the capacity to generate Maltego files that have this form. For example, if we are testing about the email addresses in a specific domain, we can generate a file of this this type. Basically it's a XML file. We have a Maltego message, Maltego transform export message, and for each result that we have found, we have entities. Entities are like nodes that we have found in this domain, and we can build this XML and passing open this file in Maltego for discover more information about this email address. This is the interface on Maltego. Maltego provides a very visual interface where we can search by domain, by IP address, by URL, website, and basically what this does is we introduce an IP address or email, and basically what this does is obtain all this information in a tree, where each node is a specific transformation that Maltego has detected in the domain that we are auditing in this case. Basically, and for each node, we can also apply all transformations that the node provides. We can, for example, if we're testing an email address, we can verify the validity of this email address. We can also check the person name, other URLs related with this email address, and so on. It's very complete for a security auditing process. Another of the tool I recommend, Spiderfoot. This tool is basically is called a footprinting. For footprinting, basically, what is that is searching public information that is available in surveys like Shodan, Virus Total, Pastebin. All services that are public and provides a service or an API and provides results about a specific domain or IP address are managed with this tool. This tool has the capacity to connect with all these data sources. Has the capacity to connect with search engines, Google, Bing, Twitter, LinkedIn, and service like check usernames for lookup the availability of popular sites of a username in the social networks. It connects with Shodan, as I comment, with Robtex, Pastebin, and other sites like Virus Total for obtain specific information about malware that can be in a IP address, for example. This tool is developed in Python 2, and also it is using the modules that we have seen before, like Beautiful Soup, this Python, Sockets, PyPDE for extracting the metadata from PDF documents, NetAddress for validating IP address, and also is using Cherry Pie. Cherry Pie is a web server for generating your web server and show the results in a web page. This is an example that is using internally the tool, basically with Beautiful Soup and Swap Trainer. We can check that with the parser LXML, we can check that it's extracting the links of a specific domain. And in a graph also, it has the capacity to show this graph where we can see that if we share by a specific domain, we obtain information, person, sites related with this domain. In this case, we are searching with the PyCon site, and we see that we obtain other information like the Twitter profile, persons, other speakers that are available in the Congress, other PyCon sites, other domains. Almeria University appears for there, and so on. All this information is related in a visual graph, and you can see in a visual model what are the terms that are related with this domain. Also, Spider4 has the capacity to connect with VirusTotal. VirusTotal provides an API for obtain more intelligence about an IP address if the domain has specific malware that has detected, and other information related with other IP addresses that are other sites. URLs detected that can allocate malware, and information about the last resolved IP address that had the site. Well, for extracting metadata, we have two ways. For if we want to extract metadata from PDF, we have the PPDF2 and PDF miner. These are the main two modules that we can find in Python for extracting the metadata. And for image, we have Pylo, the classic module in Python, and we have, depending if we are in Python 2 or Python 3, we can use PXIF2 in Python 2 and GXIF2 in Python 3. In this script counter, we can see that we can obtain basically what this module is obtain the XIF tags in the image and the GPS tags for location. For obtaining the latitude and longitude of the image, in the case that this information is available in the image. For obtaining the location, we have the UEP2 with the submodule database. We can extract from an IP address. We can obtain information about the specific domain, the location, country, city, and so on. Basically, what it does this script is open the geolite city.mmdb. This is a file that contains a lot of information about geolocations of IP address. And basically what this does is obtain is connecting to open this file, and in the case that the IP address is found in the database, returns all information. Other for printing tools that we will mention shortly are ORMB or from Epsilon GitHub. This tool, these two tools are made with Python 2, and basically what the modules are is a Python Whois, Python, Python NMAP also is using for NMAP pop export scanner. And the instant records also use request and showdown. Instant record, for example, basically what is that script, you can pass as parameter the domain that we want to extract information, and also we can has the H parameter for passing the showdown APK for obtain the same information that has seen before with showdown. We can see the same information here. This is all the information about that is extracting about the domain python.org. Basically, until now, all the tools that we have seen are developed in Python 2. But the question is, okay, I will finish because the organization is time limit. Well, basically, the question is: develop it with Python 3? Yes, it's possible. It's possible because all these modules, beautiful sub request, urlib, async IO, Robo Browser, Showdown, and so on are available in Python 3, and this is the only tool that I've seen that is developed in Python 3, but it's possible. And lastly, comment the Teamfo leak. Basically, this tool allows obtain information from Twitter. From Twitter account, it's an easy script in one file. It's a very easy script that we can obtain hashtag mentions, metadata information, geolocation of the Twitters, and so on. These are all the parameters. These are the Python defenses. It's developed in Python 2, but it's not difficult to port to Python 3. It has a very easy configuration. You have to put the consumer key of Twitter and so on. And this is the code for obtaining the geolocation. Basically what this does is the geolocation is activated in the user account. It shows this information in the report that obtains the tool. And lastly, the full content API provides in an easy way checking from an email address, checking more information about the username. Basically, what provides is that, for example, if we want to check a specific users, what are the other user accounts,